I got this in the case how long. The old service, I'm 12, so 1 hour.
1 hour.
How do you 2.5 hours?
Yeah,
you got 2 hours.
Thank you.
I'm leaving you the service. I'm okay, yeah? Yeah, you have a taxi. Come right down. Come. Yeah, you have a taxi. You can get a taxi.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. About the comments, I'm Chitty Sirlina, please. Grandfather, a brother, a brother-in-law, uncle. uncle and a friend to celebrate the life of the late Mr. Poonsamy Padiyachi, formerly known as Paddy. The dad was born on the 27th of April 1934 and departed from his loving family on the 17th of September 2023 at the rightful age of 89. He leaves wife, Gonam, also known as Sally, children Segun, Sagri and Ravi, son-in-law, Lawrence, daughters-in-law, Sharon and Rashina, grandchildren, Malaysia, Tradisha, Chanson, Malaysia, Samiksha, Kamlesh, and Pitika. Great-grandchildren Titan, Gia, and Aurora. They had also leave siblings, namely Sada, Vansila, and Tyra. And they also have loving family, friends, and loving neighbors. Ladies and gentlemen, this morning's service will be rendered by the Saraswati Service Group. And if you're familiar with the songs that we're going to sing, we'd love you to provide the service. Shall we all rise for the opening prayer, please?
Yeah. வாத்தி வணங்குவோம் மாலசிலம்பாடி, வாத்தி வணங்குவோம் மாலசிலம்பாடி, வாத்தி வணங்குவோம் ஓம் திருச்சிற்றம்பலம்.
Take your seats, thank you.
Vaaniye kolluvome appa, vaaniye kolluvome, vaaniye kolluvome appa, vaaniye kolluvome.
பிரச்சோதயா
ஓம் ஸ்ரீ கணேஷாய நமஹ. ஓம் கம் கணபதியே நமஹ. தத்புருஷாய விக்மஹே வத்ருகுண்டாய தீமஹி தன்னோ நந்தி பிரச்சோதயாத். ஓம் ஸ்ரீ கணேஷாய நமஹ.
தன் மொழியே வீராயகா கர்வேஷா வீராயகா யாகத்தன் மொழி நீங்கவும்
ஆனந்த பெருகிவும் அமதா மனதினிலே அத உச்ச பிள்ளையா போய் மலையினிலே நம்மற்றும் நீங்கவும் ஆனந்த பெருகே அமதா மனதினிலே அத உச்ச பிள்ளையா போய் அனுபவ கண்களை யாத்திரை தானும், அனுபவ கண்களை யாத்திரை தானும், அவனும் ராமனும் ஒன்றே. அன்பின் வழியில் யாழ்ந்தானும் அவனும் ராமனும் ஒன்றே, அவனும் ராமனும் ஒன்றே, அவனும் ராமனும் ஒன்றே. கண்ணீரும் திறந்தென்னே உன் காதிமே அழகி பாராமல், காலிலும் திறந்தென்னே முருகா, காலிலும் திறந்தென்னே உன் குன்றத்தில் வந்தே Thank you.
வருகுவென் அருள் புரியாயே. மதிப்பிற்குரிய நம் இசையர்களுக்கும் தாய் தந்தைமார்களுக்கும் அருமையான பிள்ளைகளுக்கும் என் இனிய அன்பு வணக்கம். அன்பர்களே, இன்று நாம் எல்லோரும் நம் அப்பா பொன்சாமி பாடியாச்சி அவர்களுக்கும் ஒரு ஆண்டு பிரார்த்தனைக்கு எல்லோரும் வருக 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 என்று வரவேற்கின்றேன். செலுட்டேஷன்ஸ் அண்ட் ப்ரொஸ்டேஷன்ஸ் at the divine lotus feet of our Supreme Lord. To our very respected musicians, family and loving friends and little spiritual darlings, my vanakkam, namaste, namaskaram, Sai Ram, Hare Krishna, and a very good morning to all of you. It's a family's request that I stand here today. Welcome you all, though it's a very cold winter's Sunday morning. You're all are here. Your presence is highly appreciated and acknowledged. And I sing that recital, it was part of every line. He says, my dear Lord, I am coming to you. Oh, lovely. He's looking at a very adorable tree with the blues. And look at the beautiful floral arrangements. He is in heaven, in a blissful heaven. Uddhava Nam Shivaya, Potriyam Nam Shivaya, is there now. I sing the recital for him too. But he must have already reached, the heavens must have already. Namashivaya, see how lovely. Nazaja is there, Ganesha is there. There's no obstacles and he is there. It's looking so adorable and awesome this morning, isn't he? Yeah. All of you are also looking admirable and adorable also. Avedam. I am singing a beautiful song about mother. Thayin sarandhe oru kovilam illai. Where in the world can you find a greater temple, a mosque or a church other than a mother? Thandhi solmikke oru mandiram illai. Who other than a father or our dad or our papa can give a better advice or lecture to a child? You don't get that in the university. Today is our own. Tomorrow, a chance may never come. In life, we face so much of challenges. The harder the struggle, the more glorious the triumph. I'm not going to speak too much of the two speakers, the family will speak, but this I was requested to come to the front and speak. In life today, we have so much of challenges, obstacles. We have load shedding, we have water shedding, we have road shedding, and there's lots of problems we have in life. You all know that we have the corruption and in our government, in our country. Sometimes there's sorrows and there's happiness. We have to face them all in life. I thought, you know, I read this sermon. It's a little bit of a humor. We always, when we come, we are sad, we are dull and gloomy. It's nice to have some happy moments also. You know, we have to, in life, we have to balance our lives. It says here, it's a little bit of a human. See, monkey and man. See, half a dozen monkeys sat on a mango tree and discussed certain things. One monkey said, now listen to me. People say that man descended from us. This is not at all true. The very idea is a disgrace to us. No monkey ever divorced his wife. You all know that. And lately now in our life we see a lot of monkeys visiting. No monkey ever starved his children. No monkey ever abandons his children. No monkey smokes, gambles, drinks, and dances in a club. No monkey suffers from syphilis and takes 606 injections. No monkey marries a fourth wife at 80. No monkey takes another monkey's life with a gun or a knife or atom bomb. Be quite sure that man did not descend from us. Strong faith, when our faith and surrender to God do not waver under any condition or circumstance, we cannot help crying out, oh Lord, understand now that thou art indeed an ocean of compassion and mercy, as whatever thou dost is for my good only. A loss on one side is really a gain on the other. In our Thirukkural, in our holy Thirukkural, it says, Malar Misi Yeginan, Manari Serndar, Nile Misi Nidu Varvar. God is within us. If we have faith and devotion and worship Him daily, we live a long and happy life. Sometimes we start going over the oceans looking for God, but God is actually within us. We can Nandri Vanakam. The other family will give us the speech on our link above.
What a lovely experience. You learned to give us such a nice in-depth knowledge. Thank you so much. Beautifully said. Thank you, ma'am. I really appreciate that. I wish you could be part of me. Our next speaker is daughter-in-law, Sharon, whom I prayed for it.
Today, we're taking time to celebrate an amazing man who had a very special heart. I am honored and privileged to be called his daughter. His love, care, respect for all of us, especially for the woman, was overwhelming. I read a little pastime just recently about, it was a pastime where Lord Ramachandra was in the forest, in the Dandika forest for 14 years. And when Mother Sita was actually abducted by Ravan, it's a year later, and my heart is still in a million pieces, so please forgive me. So well, after Ravan kidnapped Mother Sita, as she went along, there was lots of items of jewelry that she dropped. She dropped her bangles, she dropped her sirbandi and a pile. So as Lord Ramachandra went in search of Mother Sita, well, everyone here knows the story, but I'm trying to get a very, very important point across. So while he went along, Lord Ram picked up different items of Mother Sita's jewelry, and she actually showed it to Lakshman. And Lakshman looked, he was very confused because he did not recognize the jewelry. So Lord Ram looked at him and says, but this belongs to Mother Sita, Lakshman. And he still was very confused, he didn't recognize it. And eventually, as they got along, Lord Ram picked up Mother Sita's pile and he looked at it and he says, yes, this belongs to Mother Sita. And Lord Ram looked at him and he says, but so many other jewelry you didn't recognize. And that's when Lord Ram, he didn't need to say anything more because he understood at that point in time the purity of the heart of Lakshman, where he never looked at Mother Sita at her head or anything. He only meditated on Mother Sita, lotus feet, accepting her as a universal mother. And that so deeply hit me when I read this pastime. Because we don't get men in this day and age that have that respect and actually treats every woman as a mother. But my dear, dear father-in-law had that amazing ability in him where he looked at every woman as a mother. And I'll have you know, he gave us all the utmost respect as a mother. Whether it was his little granddaughters or the daughters or Rishina and I, but we were always treated and given the love as a mother, which is such a rare quality for a man to have in this day and age, because the only thing that women ever needed to be is actually protected and cared for and not abused. And he took you know, the respect for women to a real, a whole new level that each one of us can actually learn something from. A man of Daddy's caliber was so rare. And I think that era of men, having men of that stature, is over. It's sad, but I think it really is over. I will miss your acknowledgement, Dad, when I entered a room, your warm heart and your kindness. I will miss always getting your blessings, which I always had. I remember when I opened Sevika's kitchen and how happy you were. I remembered your words so clearly. You said, Sharon, you must always be independent and you must never rely on anyone for anything. Your hard work, you will always be successful by working hard. I know in my heart that I will always have your blessings in all my ventures going forward. You taught us so many valuable lessons that will help us all become better people. Your last birthday, when you turned 89, we partied all day from lunchtime, lunch at home at Ma's house, to dinner at the Pearls. I guess we knew in our hearts it might be your last with us. And it was quite a blast, to an extent where he so tiredly looked at Ma sweetly and he says, Southri, please let's go home now. Loving you was the easiest thing that I ever did. You deserved the glorious send-off that you had. Lord Krishna's mercy overflowed onto you from your last breath to your final rites. And I know Lord Krishna made the best arrangements for your annual journey because you truly were a very special soul. To the most dignified, virtuous man I knew, I salute you a million times over. Thank you for all you did for us all. The emptiness in our hearts will remain, and you will be in our hearts till the end of time. A true legend whose legacy is how dignified we live our lives, and that we promise to make you proud of us. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. A beautiful message from daughter-in-law, lovely father-in-law. Ladies and gentlemen, we call our last speaker at the end. But now we're going to go on to the service. Krishna Muganda Murare Jay Krishna Muganda Murare Jay Krishna Muganda Murare Karuna Sankara Kamala Raniga Karuna Sankara Kamala Raniga Ganagundara Nayini Gopala Ganagundara Gopala Krishna Muganda Murare Jaya Krishna Muganda Murare Kaliya Madhava Kamsari Kodana Kaliya Thank you.
குந்தளம் குவளிய தனலியம் மதுர முரளி ரமலோடும் கோடிதமதான லாவஞ்சும் கோபிய குண்ய பஜாமி கோபாலும் கோபிய ஜன மன மோகன கோபிய ஜன மன மோகன கோபிய ஜன மன மோகன ஜாபத கோபிய ஜன மன மோகன ஜாபத குவளி தன்னீலம் கோபால குவளி தன்னீலம் கோபால கிருஷ்ண மோகந்த முரே கிருஷ்ண மோகந்த முரே கருணாசன் கர கமலாநாயக கருணாசன் கர கமலாநாயக கணகுந்தரநயகி கோபால கணகுந்தரநயகி கோபால
Shivaya Shivaya Namah Shivaya பாடும் பலவித நாடும் கல்லையேறும்
Sound. You got sound. Pause. Go back.
Thank you.
you, ladies and gentlemen, for the beautiful life of our dear dad, scripted by Satan. Ladies and gentlemen, we now move on to the second half, which is the most important part, where we can come and offer a prayer to our dear dad. We're going to call up the immediate family first, followed by friends and relatives and neighbors. We will now sing the Tevarams. There's a mouse rules to follow when you come to the altar. You're going to turn the lamp 3 times. You're going to offer the water 3 times. The flower petals on the left-hand bucket. You're going to turn it around the photograph and put it into the right-hand bucket. We're going to do a prayer. If you want to kneel down, you can kneel. You can put your dot, and you can recite back to your place. We'll call up the media family first, and follow our friends in the town.
So divine heaven.
போற்றுனை தீரந்தடி போர்ந்த கை தொழ சோற்றுனை வேதிய சோதி வாழவன் போற்றுனை தீரந்தடி போர்ந்த கை தொழ காற்றுனை போற்றியோ
Amen. Thank you. நீ
விமலனே நம சிவாயா, விமலனே நம சிவாயா, விமலனே நம சிவாயா, விமலனே நம சிவாயா, விமலனே நம சிவாயா. ஐமுறை ஆடை பாடும் அம்பிலன் தலமாய் வைத்து செய்யானுபானோ போற்றும் தேவனே நம சிவாயா, தேவனே நம சிவாயா, தேவனே நம சிவாயா, தேவனே நம சிவாயா, தேவனே நம சிவாயா. ஒன்பதோழ்வாயல் தோட்டம் உறங்கினி உயமம் வண்ணம் பொன்பொதி மலராய் காட்டும் புனிதனே நம சிவாயா, புனிதனே நம சிவாயா, புனிதனே நம சிவாயா, புனிதனே நம சிவாயா, புனிதனே நம சிவாயா. ஓம்மனம் எழுக்க நல்ல உலகே விலங்கள் நின்று மாமான கருணாய் நிலகம் வல்லலே நம சிவாயா, வல்லலே நம சிவாயா, வல்லலே நம சிவாயா, வல்லலே நம சிவாயா, வல்லலே நம சிவாயா. ஆவியும் பேச வண்ணும் அதிமலை தலத்தாய் கொள்ளும் தேவிய முனிய தேவனே நம சிவாயா, தேவனே நம சிவாயா, தேவனே நம சிவாயா, தேவனே நம சிவாயா, தேவனே நம சிவாயா. ஐந்தே கொண்ட கொண்டன் அறிவனே நீரோ பூசும் சொக்கனா சேகாமேனி தூயனே நம சிவாயா, தூயனே நம சிவாயா, தூயனே நம சிவாயா, தூயனே நம சிவாயா, தூயனே நம சிவாயா. கம்பரா கிளறித்து காட்சியா கம்ப சேப்போன் அம்பலா காடோ என்றே அன்பே நம சிவாயா, அன்னலே நம சிவாயா, அன்னலே நம சிவாயா, அன்னலே நம சிவாயா, அன்னலே நம சிவாயா. ஞான போல் விலக ஒன்று ஞாயிறின் அருவே தீரும் பருகழா ஈனா தீக்கும் பரமனே நம சிவாயா, பரமனே நம சிவாயா, பரமனே நம சிவாயா, பரமனே நம சிவாயா, பரமனே நம சிவாயா. சக்தியும் சிவமும் ஆகி தானக ஜெகத்தைக்கெல்லாம் முக்திய அலப்பாயாடி முதல்வனே நம சிவாயா, முதல்வனே நம சிவாயா, முதல்வனே நம சிவாயா, முதல்வனே நம சிவாயா, முதல்வனே நம சிவாயா. ஓம் சக்தி ஓம் சக்தி ஓம் சக்தி ஓம் சக்தி ஓம் சக்தி ஓம் சக்தி ஓம் ஓம் சக்தி ஓம் சக்தி ஓம் ஓம் சக்தி 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 ஓம் நாராயணன் நாராயண ஓம் சக்தி நாராயண 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 ஓம் நாராயண நாராயண ஓம் நாராயண நாராயண ஓம் சக்தி நாராயண நாராயண சக்தி நாராயண நாராயண ஓம், நாராயண நாராயண ஓம், நாராயண நாராயண ஓம், நாராயண நாராயண ஓம். ஓம் திருச்சிற்றம்பலம். Ladies and gentlemen, we have now come to the end of this afternoon's service. And before we close, we have one special speaker. She's the only daughter of our dad. Her name is Segri, and she will now pay a lovely tribute. And we kept the best for the last. So Segri will now come up and pay a tribute to her dad.
Take this moment today and look at each and every one of your faces and try not to get emotional as I give my speech today. It was quite moving to see the slideshow, and I thought and I hoped that I would deliver my speech long before the slideshow comes up. But, you know, as God will have it, I must deliver the speech last. Thank you so much. I know my daughter is going to give the thank yous verse in the speech in the end, but I want to take this opportunity to thank each and every one of you for taking the time off and attending today Dad's 1 year memorial service. Mom, love you so much. My heart goes out to you. I'm going to try and be strong as I say the speech. I love you, I love you, I love you. Here goes. My humble greetings to family and friends. Together, we gather together to commemorate the 1 year memorial service of my beloved dad, the late Ponnusamy Pediachi, better known as Paddy. Love you, Dad. It is indeed a honor and a privilege to pay a heartfelt tribute to Dad, who was called to rest on the 17th of September 2023, just 7 months shy of him turning 90. While earth has lost a valuable soul, heaven has gained. He was a son, father, father-in-law, grandfather, great-grandfather, brother, uncle, and friend. He was one of the most dynamic, dedicated, hard-working, spontaneous, courageous, generous, patient, understanding, loving, fiercely independent, and powerful man. And I must emphasize the words powerful man I have ever known. He was able to bring to the surface parts of himself that were only exposed through humble simplicity and a heart connected to love. We will always be thankful for the influence and the profound impact Dad had on our lives and the lasting memories he shared with us all. A phenomenal being. That is who he will be remembered as. His existence transcends all barriers. He was family orientated. He respected and cherished us all and held to old-fashioned values which helped us to be who we are today. If I can use an analogy to better describe Dad, he was a lantern that went around shining his bright light. He was the glue. Relationships was never a problem to Dad. It came from the heart. It was there to enhance our lives, to fill the gaps. He had a strong sense of family value. His acts of selflessness inspired me to be a better person. He remained true to himself, consistent from childhood days. He carried that love into his adulthood. Dad left behind a rich legacy. I now invite you to join me down memory lane of Dad's life. Dad was born and raised at Belair Road, Cater Manor. During the period 1st September 1939 through to 2nd September 1945, when World War II impacted the globe as a whole, Dad got to experience history in the making at the tender age of 5. At the tender age of 10, he worked ardently on their farm in Cater Manor, which provided fresh fruit and vegetables to be sold at their store at Top Market. Dad also experienced the Durban 1949 riots, where an anti-Indian massacre took place. At 6 a.m. on Friday, 14 January 1949, our grandfather, Mr. Vayapuri Padiyachi, that is Dad's father, age 54 then, owner of stall number 72, together with his three sons, which included Dad, who was 15 years, went to work at Victoria Street Market, known as Top Market. As the day progressed, the violence intensified, resulting in the Top Market gates closing. Some stall owners left early, but some, like Granddad and his sons, had no transport to get back home and had to sit at their stall from 2 p.m. to midnight. In the early hours of the next morning, a white man who was transporting Indians to their homes at a fee arrived at the market, and Granddad and his sons seized the opportunity to get back home. On their way, violence spiraled out of control and the driver was injured. However, he managed to drive to a police station where he dropped them off and he was taken to hospital. At the age of 18, he worked for R.M. Naidu as an accounting clerk, whilst at the same time he pursued his tertiary education at Emerald Sultan and successfully obtained a diploma in accounting. At the age of 21, Uncle Sunny, Mike's dad, and his brother-in-law Frank successfully cycled to Pietermaritzburg, a total of 170 kilometers, that's return trip. At 23, Dad worked at Enamel Products and Edward Hotel. At the age of 27, he married his lifetime partner, Savitri. My beautiful mom is sitting right here. And went on to have three children, Ravi, Sagrin, and of course, beautiful me. On the 7th of June 1966, Dad had the honor of meeting Senator Robert Kennedy at Odell Edward. Here he was handed a half a dollar specially minted in memory of the 35th President, US President John F. Kennedy. At the age of 33, Dad purchased our very home, first home in Montfort, Chatsworth. Uncle Sada, that's Dad's brother, accepted Dad's invitation to live with us, a selfless act of both my parents. At the age of 39, we moved into our new home in Mubeni Heights, where Uncle Sada also accompanied us. Dad invited his brothers, Uncles Aya and Digal, with their families to take up residence at our previous home in Montfort, Chatsworth, another selfless act of my parents. We saw my parents' generosity unfold even further as my parents welcomed Auntie Baby's three children at varying intervals to live with us at our home. My parents had compassion to make great sacrifices for the benefit of others. They would always go the extra mile. At the age of 43, Dad embarked on running his own business in the field of retaining walls. From the age of 44 through to 65, Dad was engaged as a salesman with various companies in retaining walls. At the same time, successfully ran his business as an accountant and tax practitioner. He continued in private practice as an accountant and tax practitioner up to the age of 89 and terminated his service when he was hospitalized in August of 2023. Dad continued to work into his retirement as he was fiercely independent, dedicated, passionate about his work. While I am on the topic, I recall Dad meticulously writing up yearly logbook. And for those that know what logbooks entail, it's tedious. I should know all about that. Final set of accounts and financial statements manually. Thereafter, Ravi would transfer this information into the Word document, while his secretary, Samishka, who's hiding right there on the side, granddaughter, remained hard at work, making copies and assisting her grandfather wherever possible. Mind you, Dad made certain she got paid for the job well done. And Sam, thank you so much, doll, for helping Dad. In addition, she would timelessly provide Dad with these medications and be of assistance whenever he required. Materialistic things did not matter to Dad. He celebrated life. And I must stress this word, celebrate. Very few of us actually celebrate life. It's like a torment, it's like a torment for them. If I may indulge you further, he loves celebrating mom and his birthdays, anniversaries, and he would insist on paying the bill. We couldn't pay anything. He would pay for that, the birthdays and the anniversaries. He enjoyed cleaning herbs. Oh my God. And for me, this is such a tiring and a boring task. He loved cooking. And his food was absolutely delicious. He would take the grandkids to school and it never tired him out. When he picked them up from school, he would give them money to buy whatever their little hearts desired while he kept a close eye on them. Whenever I needed Dad's help, he was there in a heartbeat. These were just few memories I wish to share today. Now I can go on speaking volumes, but I will remain mindful of the time limit. But I would like to say thank you, Dad, for spending your journey with us, for enriching us greatly. Your heartfelt love, your sacrifice will be etched in our hearts forever. Love you, Dad. Thank you.
Thank you so much, beautiful tribute. We now will call the granddaughter to pay the vote of thanks. Renisha.
Good afternoon, everybody. I just want to firstly say thank you for the really big turnout. I saw like a table empty here, and then Mel and family brought it in and just filled it up. It really makes me very glad and happy to see the turnout. Thank you. I'm a little bit nervous. I said I'm just going to come up here and speak and give a vote of thanks. And I'm really glad that I could be here. I could come through and just be a part of this. So I just want to say, just firstly, if we could, I see that everyone has some beverages on their table. If we could pour just a little bit and we can just give a little toast to my granddad, just to celebrate his life. Because I think people forget, you know, when you lose somebody, it's also about celebration. Because the time we had with him was definitely a celebration to be experienced. So if we can just pour a little something and we can raise our glass to a toast, I'd appreciate that.
Thank you.
see some empty glasses. I like that. As long as you're holding something, it's good. Okay, so I just want to give a toast to our Tata, Punasamy Pariyarji. And I like to say the man, the myth, the legend. And may he live on. So, here's to him. Cheers.
Amen. Cheers.
Okay, so I'm here mainly for the vote of thanks. So, I'd like to thank everybody for taking out time from your Sunday just to be here and share it with us, because time is such a precious thing. It's here today, it's gone tomorrow. So I want to thank you for taking the time out, spending it with us, because it means the world to us. It's something that is more valuable than anything in this world. So thank you for sharing that with us. I would also like to thank Amshwatazana Temple Hall. It actually very nice space. And I would like to thank the Saraswati Service Group. I think this is my second or third time hearing you. And I have to say, wow, you bring the energy. We really feel it in our soul. So thank you so much for an amazing service. We all appreciate it very much. Thank you. I would also like to thank Deluxe Caterers. They've catered for us for our lunch and the wonderful decor that we have here today. I'd also like to thank Mayabang Funeral Services, as well as to our speakers. It takes a lot of courage to come out here to prepare, and especially when there's so much of emotions involved. So thank you so much for coming and speaking and sharing your journey with the rest of us as well. I would like to also thank Krishna Mama, Auntie Angie and family, as well as Tata's brothers, Uncle Sada, Uncle Gonsil, and Uncle Tyron, as well as Auntie Shirley, there we go, and Uncle Carson. Thank you everybody for attending today, and may the rest of your Sunday go pleasantly, and let's enjoy the rest of today here with everybody. Thank you so much.
Is of the essence. And then I'm sure you won't mind when the beautiful ladies come up to the mic. sometimes we speakers do forget certain things. Last night we were at my late sister's in 40 days Thanksgiving service, and there the pastor said he's actually crying for his mother. Though the mother is late, mother and father are late, but it's actually crying. And I also feel the same. I also always cry for my mother, but nobody knows about it. That's how important the parents are. Blessed are those who have parents, and blessed are those who worship the parents. And finally, what I'm going to say, our handsome musicians, they look absolutely handsome. Acknowledges them. I'm sad. What I was actually going to say, I've forgotten that name also. On the 21st of July is Guru Purnima. It's a very important day for our gurus. And I said, no, I must acknowledge them. He says, the guru is a medium through which the grace of God flows to its devotees. They are our gurus also. See, Mada, Pita, Guru, Devam, so they are also our gurus. So on the 21st of July, it's a special day for its Guru Purnima. It's important. So we acknowledge them and we say that, you know, they, holding that Tamil flag, I, Vajga Tamil, Balarga Tamil. And on that same particular day, also on June 21st, our mother, Adi Parasati, is descending on Earth. So it's very important. Adi Parasati will be descending. So we all be observing a Vaman prayer. Mikkel Nandri Vanakkam. Have a pleasant enjoy your lunch and pleasant day. Thank you so much.
Such an intelligent little woman. Ladies and gentlemen, we now come to the end of this afternoon service. We now call up the immediate family to come through to the last Ibaradhanai. Shall we all rise for the concluding prayer, please?
சுகிந்தம் புஷ்டிவர்தனம் உர்வாரோ கமிவா பந்தரா நித்யோன்முக்ஷம் அம்ருதம் ஓம் த்ரியம்பகம் யஜாமஹ சுகந்தம் புஷ்டி வர்தனம் உர்வாரூகமிவா வந்தனா நித்யோன்முக்ஷம் அம்ருதம் ஓம் த்ரியம்பகம் யஜாமஹ சுகந்தம் புஷ்டி வர்தனம் உர்வாரூகமிவா வந்தனா நித்யோன்முக்ஷம் அம்ருதம் கல்லாப்ரியம் கருதாப்ரியம் கசுந்தரிகை எல்லாப்ரியம் நினையாப்ரியம் நினைங்கிறத்தை சொல்லாப்ரியம் துரியாப்ரியம் தோழாப்ரியம் எல்லாப்ரியம் கொழுத்தரவாயே கச்சீகும்வன அருட்பெரும் ஜோதி தனி பெரும் கருணை தனி பெரும் கருணை அருட்பெரும் ஜோதி ஓம் நம சிவாய ஓம் நம சிவாய ஓம் நம சிவாய ஓம் சாந்தி 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 எல்லோருக்கும் வணக்கம் நமஸ்காரம் நமஸ்தே ஓம் சாராம் டேக் யூர் சீட்ஸ் தேங்க்யூ The service rendered by the Saraswati Service Group, my company musicians for this afternoon, on tabla is Mr. Theo Manray, on harmonium is Mervyn Ramasamy, and my name is Mervyn Kiston. We'd like to thank Ravi and his family for allowing us to be part of the service. Thank you very much. Please do not leave the premises without partaking in a lovely lunch provided by Malmi, the deluxe caterers. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Mika Mika Nandri, please drive home safely. Manakunji.
Okay. Thank you.